Yeah, good morning YouTube. Just finishing up a test print here. So this is some ABS. This is from Amazon, some of their generic ABS from Design Shop. And what I found for printing, I did 235C on the extruder, a little bit hotter than they say, 115C on the bed. I used a glue stick on the bed, turned off the fans, 60 millimeters per second. So what I'm doing is making a spool holder for my nylon filament, which comes in about a 6-inch wide, 150 millimeter wide spool. It's a lot wider than the supplied filament holders. Okay, there you go, YouTube. Finished printing the two side brackets for the spool holder. So I'm just gonna wait for the bed to cool a little bit, and I will pull those off, clean off the little brim. Yeah, I can hear these starting to pop loose now. So yeah, once that build plate cools off, I'll pop these off, clean them up, and I'll show you what the finished spool holder looks like. So we'll catch you later then. Okay, so that was a pretty tight fit on the spool. Well, that's the nice thing with this design, you just have to print a new bar. Maybe make that about 210, 220 millimeters. Yeah, good morning YouTube. So this is the filament spool stand I'm trying to print for my nylon printer filament, and I've brought them into Cura here. So I can go over here, file, load, and since I need the longer bar, I'll go with the 150 millimeter to start with. Yes, I went to 210, which scaled the X by 40%. The Y and the Z remained the same. That way the bar still fits into the side pieces. And all I need to do here is show you that dialogue here. I just say that. And there we go. Got the finished part on the cooling on the bed there. So I think it's fairly cool. I think I'll take it off, clean it up, and see if that fits our filament spool. Yeah, there we go, YouTube. I think that's the magic size. I did 210 millimeters on the bar length, and that lets the spool spin pretty freely there. I don't know what happened on this side, because this one's all deformed. I think 200 would work well for a nice flat spool like you have on that side. This one, because that was the side that was up when I took the measurement, and I forgot to check the opposite side. So yeah, 200 if you have a nice clean spool, or 210 I think if you have one like that. But that works pretty good, and it's fairly stable, just snaps together. All you need to do is just a little bit of sanding, take the ridges off the print. And otherwise it goes in there, snaps right in, and so I think I will give that a try next little bit later today, see if I can figure out this nylon filament. Just thought I'd show you the finished product, first 3D print, and yeah. So if you have any comments or questions, put that in the comment section below, and as always, thanks for watching.